Hi guys, I'm Taylor and I'm one of TCTA's film teachers, and today I'm going to teach you Celtx.com, which is a free online script writing software that you can use to get started writing your own scripts. So let's jump in.
Okay, so you're going to go to Celtx.com, Celtx.com, and you're going to sign up for an account. It's free. Once you do that, you're going to sign in, and when you go to your homepage, it's going to look a little like this. You can only have three projects open at a time, which would be the ones in white. However, I have the little gray bar. That's because I also have Celtx downloaded on my laptop, which I kind of paid a little bit for, so I can have much more options as far as how many projects I have open at one time. So you're going to go ahead and go to New Project, and we're going to go to Film and TV, and you're going to type in the name of your project, and mine's going to be TCTATQ because we're totally cool, totally art, totally quarantined. Then you're going to open the new thing, and you're going to go to Screenplay. These are just options to help you organize your ideas, but Screenplay is where you're going to go in and actually start your project. Once that opens, it's going to bring up a little blank page like this, and you're going to have the gray bar at the top, which is your scene heading. Over there on the left top corner, there's like a drop-down menu, and that's the different things that you can cycle between. So we're not going to really use act. That's more for the theater type things. We're going to do scene heading, action, character, dialogue, parenthetical. We're not going to use transitions a whole lot, as well as we're not going to really do a whole lot of shot or text. I can get into that in later lessons, but for now, just focus on the scene heading through the parenthetical. So when you start, you're going to go in and you're going to say INT, living room, and it's day. INT refers to where the camera is located. So INT is interior, so it's inside the living room during the day. Now, if it was outside, exterior, living room, day, then that would mean that the camera is placed outside. But you would kind of want to put like exterior living room window, knowing that the camera is outside the living room looking through the window into the living room. Just to be a little more specific for whoever is reading your screenplay so they get an idea of where you're at. You can also do exterior front lawn because obviously the front lawn is outside, the camera's outside, and it's during the day, or it can be at night. So once you've figured out where we are, which in this case we're going to put interior living room, day, we're then going to move over to our action. And see, when I click tab, it changes the action over in the top left side. So we're going to introduce our character, Taylor. When you're introducing a character for the first time, you're going to always put their name in capital letters because you're seeing that character for the very first time. You're then going to place their age in commas, and then after that, you're going to give them a little bit of a description as to who they are, and then you're going to tell what they're doing. So in this case, we have two characters, one after the other. So Taylor, 27, artsy mom, sits on her couch watching Tiger King, while Oliver, 2, plays in the floor with his Hot Wheels. So there you go. You have a little bit of an action of what's going on in the scene. Now you're going to hit tab again, and it's going to take you over to characters. You're going to type in your character that talks first. In this case, it's Taylor. Ignore this. This is just part of Grammarly that I have on my laptop. It tries to change everything. Anyways, after that, you're going to put on what Taylor says. So Taylor says, Oliver, hun, try to be a little more quiet because mommy is trying to hear her show, hear why Carol Baskin is so awful. If you've watched Tiger King yet, then you understand this reference. If not, well, It's okay. So next we're going to go over, so right now it's on character. You're going to hit tab again, or I think it's enter. You go to the next character, you type in the next character, you hit it again, and it changes the tab to dialogue. If you ever have any problems with it changing, you can actually go up there and click it and it'll change it for you. But right now we're going to put in parenthetical. So parenthetical is kind of direct how a character does something, how they say something, or something that they do right before they say it. In this case, we're going to say that Oliver points his finger at his mom. And usually you would say like this in the case of there being multiple people in the room, like say there was someone other than Taylor and Oliver, there's like Taylor, Oliver, and Josie, which we'll get into a later list. Get into in a later lesson, then it would be really imperative that you put that he points his finger at Taylor so that everyone knows that he's pointing it at Taylor and not Josie. Now he does that and then says, "No, mommy," it's in capital letters, so like kind of to give you a point that he's screaming this at her. And then we go on and she responds to him, and that's how you go about all of that. Now, so they've had a little bit of dialogue. We are going to then change it over until we have action. You can hit tab until it goes to action. And we're going to say a little bit of what's happening after that. In this case, Oliver now is not capitalized because we've already introduced him in the first action sequence. So therefore, we don't have to capitalize his name anymore from here on out. It can just be, you know, spelled regularly. So he ignores Taylor and he continues to play with his Hot Wheels. Now, we don't normally have to put like this much detail into some of this. I mean, you can say he ignores Taylor, but the more detail, the better. Also, everything that you say needs to be in present tense. It can't be in past tense in any way because everything is happening in the moment. Now, see how I said that he plays with his Hot Wheels while making a loud vroom noise. Anytime that there's any type of noise in an action, it needs to be capitalized to tell the reader, the director, the cinematographer, anybody who's working on the set, that that is an actual noise that needs to be heard, whether it's from the character or in post. Any type of noise needs to be capitalized at all times. Now, we're going to say that that scene is over with. And we're going to move on to the next scene, which you would then push tab on and till you hit scene heading, and it brings back the gray bar. And you, in this case, we're in interior kitchen night. So
you'll just do this over and over again until you've had a completed story. You'll hit enter, you'll go down to the next thing, hit tab until you're in action. If it doesn't already put you there, like again, I said, you can use the drop down bar to get to that place as well. Write your action out, say what the characters have to say, go to the next scene over and over and over again. In further lessons, I'll go into more detail about some of the ways in which you can bring more characters in, maybe do some like flashback things or anything like that if you're interested. I just hope that you're using your social distancing time to maybe create some content that maybe later on you guys can film yourselves, because you know this is a good art to learn how to do. And have fun, guys.